Hey guys, it's Sarah, and today is Booklist Thursday. This is a video series I do with my friend Lindsay over at Lindsay's Little Library. And every Thursday, we bring you a fun list, something we feel like talking about, surrounding books, somehow, whatever we feel like doing. And today, we're going to be having a fun topic. We are also going to be joined by someone else. So the first thing I want to tell you is that we are going to be joined for the first 3 weeks in December. We're going to have a guest person joining us, and that is going to be Krista from Books and Jams. She's going to join us for the first 3 weeks for our prompts, and I'm super, super excited about that. So I'm going to leave both Lindsay and Krista linked down below so you guys go check out their videos for today. Okay, so the prompt that we're doing today is don't judge these books by their covers. Because we tend to do that, right? We tend to cover buy books, something with a beautiful cover, so it must be a beautiful book, so we buy it without even, you know, thinking about what the book is actually about, or if it's a bad cover, sometimes we'll rock by them because we assume they're bad books, something like that. So we thought it would be fun to show you some books that we think do not match their covers. So the first one for me is The Daughter of Smoke and Bone by Lainey Taylor. I do not like these covers. These are the US covers. I don't like them at all. I think they're kind of ugly. I actually like the UK covers better, definitely. Not enough to replace them, because once I finish this trilogy, which I haven't, I've only read this first one. I do have the other two. I do want to finish this trilogy. I don't know if I'll keep them on my shelves or not. Depends on how the rest of the trilogy goes. But I did really love this first book, but the covers are really ugly. The next one is a book I actually just finished, and that's It's Always the Husband by Michelle Campbell. Michelle Campbell has two covers that are similar to this. The other one is She Was the Quiet One, and it's with like a silhouette of a face and then another image kind of overlapping it, and they kind of blend together. I don't really like that. It reminds me of that Will Ferrell picture where he takes this picture where it's like, you know, him looking onto the camera and then another huge blowout of his face that overlaps it. I can't take it seriously. So that has completely ruined any cover that looks like this for me. That's all I see in my head. And yeah, so I don't love the cover, but I did really like this book a lot. Okay, so the rest of these, I don't have physical copies of these books, so I'm just going to have to talk about them. But the next one is Vicious by V.E. Schwab. Now, I'm talking about the original cover of this one. The new ones that they re-released with that match with Vengeful, I actually really like. But the older ones, I don't love those. It's like a weird illustration, and it's, you know, it's got him looking over the city, which I guess it kind of makes sense. It never appealed to me, you know, when I was thinking about reading this book in the first place. But yeah, so like I didn't love the cover, the original cover of it. I do like the newer one, but I loved the book. Like that was a 5-star read for me for sure. Another one that's kind of in the same vein as It's Always the Husband and Will Ferrell is The Wife Between Us by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Buchanan. And it's just, you know, it's the double face type thing. I don't love it. I don't love it. I think there could have been a cooler, different type of cover. I don't know what I would have done, but I don't know. But the book itself, again, was a 5-star read, but I don't love the cover. Now, the last one's going to be Opposite. I actually really like this cover a lot, and it appeals to me, and I was drawn to it every time I saw it in the store, and then I read the book, and it was a 1-star read, and that's The Mister by E.L. James. I like the cover. I really do. I think it's really beautiful, actually, but yeah, the inside, no. The inside was awful, and I will never read another E.L. James book again. Nope. It was bad, guys. It was bad. Okay, that is going to be it for my books for Don't Judge a Book by These Covers. Some of them were really good books that have bad covers. One was a really good cover that was bad book. So let me know what your answers are down below. Let me know a really good book you've read, but you can't stand the cover of it. And make sure you go check out Lindsay and Krista today. I'll have them both linked down below, see what they have to say. I'm really excited to see that. And I'm really excited that Krista is going to be joining us for the first 3 weeks of December. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, that's going to be it for me. Hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you again soon. Bye.